Okay, so now we're going to have a look at this other example. So this is the differential equation we looked at in lectures. And now what I want to do is take this template that I had used in my previous example and change the function and the initial values. So I will take the initial values t1 and y1, dt and nmax. So my t1 is now 2, my y1 is now 3, dt 0.05, and my nmax is 20. So my t1 is the starting point of the t vector, y1 is the starting point of the y vector. I need to change my function, and it's always a good idea to type these out. So it's going to be absolute value t times y divided by hyperbolic 10 t plus 20 times cos of y minus t cubed. And the rest of the code is the same. Just pull this plot back in. Now, I won't bother saving it as a separate file because I'm just working with this as a template. So if I hit run, I'll get actually what I should do. Let's type clear. Oh, these artifacts here, because I didn't clear out my workspace. So it was junk left over from last time. So now if I run it, you get a much nicer plot. So now I can make this more accurate. So this looks fairly jagged here. Step sizes aren't so small. So if I change the step size 5 times smaller, I increase the number of steps by a factor of 5. Everything else is the same. I run it, the curve smooths out, and it'll be a more accurate approximation to the true answer. And essentially, for this course, that's as much as you need to do dealing with all of these examples. So you might wish to lay out this more cleanly, and even put some, so you know you've got starting t value, starting y value, your time step, and your number of steps. Just initializing a vector of t and y values to find the function. And then this is the iterative part of Euler's method, and just a plot. Change this to a r just for fun. I'll run it again. We get a red curve, and we change it to double dash, we get a dashed curve. So there are different effects you can do. For instance, if you wanted to plot two graphs, you have one in red dashed and one in blue solid, for instance, for comparison.